Notion just launched some exciting new features, from small quality of life updates to larger features that we have been waiting for years. In this video, we'll be covering all of the recent Notion updates, as well as how you can start implementing into your own workspaces. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. The first major update we wanted to talk about is that Notion Calendar is now available on Android. So if you've been hesitating to use Notion Calendar because it's not available for mobile use, now's your chance to start using Notion Calendar. We have a full tutorial and guide that we'd highly recommend you to check out if you're interested in getting started with it. The next update we wanted to discuss is suggested edits. And this is really useful if you are collaborating through text. So if you want to turn this on, basically go to the top right hand corner, three dots, and then you can turn on this toggle suggested edits. Once it's in suggesting mode, for example, you can write things into the text that you would suggest. So this is just an example. This is a sample of a written text that we, let's say that we wanted to put wanted to show you how to use this feature, and then period. And if you're happy with this, then you can see that organized notebook suggested these edits. And then if we go back here and toggle it off, anyone can see the suggested edits. And if we click one, you can choose to either accept it, reject it, add a reaction, or there's more actions like copy the link to the discussion. So this is really useful. So for example, you could do something like, this is not a good idea, and then continue a discussion here, or you can just accept it and then it just shows up into the text. So this is a really great collaborative feature. So the next thing we wanted to show you are some game-changing AI updates. With Notion AI, some of these updates are that, for example, you can go to this Notion AI down here and basically just click on an option that they suggest so that you don't have to actually type in prompts. The other thing is that you'll notice on the left-hand sidebar, a place called Notion AI, and you can basically focus here without having any distractions and really interact with the AI in this location. If we go to, for example, our Chrome browser, and let's say that we want to access Notion AI, you can now do this from anywhere by typing Shift Command J to pull it up, which makes it a really useful AI helper. And you can also get information from your Slack, not only your Notion, because of the integration, and more are coming soon. So this makes Notion AI a little bit more useful in terms of its functionalities, as it now works across Notion and while you're working in other platforms. So the next major update we wanted to cover is an improved inbox. Before, inboxes were a little bit harder to use, but now with this update, if you click it open and then you click this button here, you can actually lock it so that it stays in place while you resolve all of your notifications. So for example, you could go here and then resolve that, and then you can go to another place to resolve another thing. So it just makes the whole workflow a lot simpler. If you want to hide it again, you simply close the inbox pane. The next thing we wanted to talk about are updates on the integrations. So first, you can import from Asana, and you can basically choose which projects you'd like to bring over and convert them into easy to use Notion databases. Jira is also improved now, so the Jira Sync integration now offers faster syncs, more customization, and upgraded database functionality. So if you're a Jira user, make sure to keep an eye out on that. The next thing we wanted to cover are some huge database improvements. So if we have the sample database here, if you click the three dots here and then you go to customize sample database, you'll notice that now it's easier to see what kinds of features are available for databases. So you can simply add sub items, dependencies, tasks to your home, as well as AI summary. And you can also see a huge list of all of the possibilities of what you can add to your database. So this makes it a little bit more intuitive on what you can accomplish with a Notion database. The other big change, especially with the automations, is that you can go to the automation button here, plus new automation. And now you can actually add multiple triggers that all need to be met before an action is automated. So for example, if we click plus add trigger, so the first trigger could be that a page is added, and then you could add another one that the name is sample. And if both are met, then we can go ahead and change the tag to done and clear tags and then create. So now you can see when page is added and name is set to sample clear tags. So you can basically add two different kinds of triggers that both need to happen before the automation is triggered. This is useful if you want something to be set to high priority, for example, and you needed it to be overdue and urgent, then you could move a task to somewhere else, for example. The other thing is that when you edit this, now if you click this open, you can easily edit these as well. So you don't have to restart from the beginning or anything, and that makes it easier as well. The next update we wanted to talk about, which everyone has been waiting for years, and that is charts. So you no longer have to use third-party tools if you want to display your data in Notion into a more visual way. So in this case, we have a sample where we just listed some habits and the number of times you did them, just to show you very basically. We'll be doing a deep dive about charts in a future video, so this is just a brief introduction to it. But basically, what you can now do is, for example, we can go to the three dots here and then go to layout, and then we can choose chart. And once you choose chart, you can edit the chart. So there are multiple types of charts available. So you can have a vertical bar, a horizontal bar, a line, or a donut. So these are what each of them would look like, something like this. And basically in this case, since it's a habit and then you want to see the number here, this is basically what we would want to see in this scenario. You can do things like sort by, omit zero values, changing the y-axis. You can also change the color styles, which is great. We love all of these color options, so that is really wonderful. You can also do more style options like the height, the grid line, axis name, color by value, data label. So there's going to be a lot of customization that is going to be available with charts. One thing to know about charts is that it's only going to be available for one free if you have a free plan on Notion per workspace. If you have the plus plan, you can have unlimited charts. So this is something that might convince some people to upgrade to the plus plan if you're really into this chart layout and you'd like to visualize your data. If you only need one chart, then the free plan could work perfectly for you as well. So we can't wait to dive further into this charts feature, but for now, we hope that everyone will start to experiment with it and see what kinds of dashboards and layouts can be made with this. Thank you so much for watching. Feel free to let us know which update is your favorite. Let us know if you have any questions or comments, and we hope to see you all in the next video.